Welcome to another Bread for a Friend. Thank you so very much for taking time to view this video today. We've been looking over the last several weeks at Revelation chapter 22, verse 20, where Jesus said, "Surely I come quickly." And we're looking at the subject, the return of Christ. Jesus is coming again. We've looked at the promises, the prophecies. Then we looked at the person, this same Jesus. We looked at the promptness. He said, come quickly. There's a set time. Then we began looking at the particulars of the return of Christ in 1 Thessalonians chapter number 4. We looked that there's going to be a resurrection of the saints, those who've died in Christ. Then we talked about the reunion. There will be a reunion. We are going to see our loved ones again, those who were saved. Boy, I'm glad of that. I've got loved ones that were saved, and they prayed for me, and they witnessed to me. Boy, they had a part in me getting born again, and I'm looking forward to seeing them again. I realize the main person we're looking for is Jesus. I know that, but I'm going to tell you, I still live in this earthly body, and I miss loved ones just like you do. We're going to see them again. So there's the resurrection. There's going to be reunion. But there's rapture. And what I mean by that, we that are alive, we're getting changed. For the Bible said, "For this we say to you by the word of the Lord, that we which are alive and remain, we that are on this earth at the coming of the Lord." We've not died. He said this, "Unto the coming of the Lord shall not prevent them which are asleep, for the Lord himself shall descend from heaven with a shout, with the voice of the archangel, with the trump of God, and the dead in Christ rise first. Then we which are alive remain shall be caught up together with them in the clouds." There's going to be a change. The book of 1 Corinthians chapter 15 again, we find he speaks to us in the moment, in the twinkling of an eye. There is going to be a change of this body. The natural is going to become supernatural. We're going to leave a temporal body for an eternal body. We're getting a glorified body, a body fashioned unto his body. 1 John 3 speaks to us of this great fact. I thought about these verses over and over again as we study the scripture. Let me just read these. I can quote it, but I like to just read them just right out of the scripture sometimes as well, because it stirs my heart. I thank God for it. He said there in 1 John chapter 3, verses 1 through 3, "Behold, what manner of love the Father hath bestowed upon us, that we should be called the sons of God. Therefore the world knoweth us not, because it knew him not. Beloved, now," I thank God for that, "present salvation. Now are we the sons of God. Doth not yet appear what we shall be. But we know that when he shall appear, we shall be like him. For we shall see him as he is. And every man that hath this hope in him purifieth himself even as he is pure." So we're going to have a body like his. We're going to have a glorified body. There's an old song that says, "I'm going to have a new body someday, and I'll sing and I'll shout, and it'll never wear out." I'm glad we're getting a new body. This body I'm in now, I know sickness, I know trouble, I know restlessness, I know spiritual tension, but thank God one day, in the moment, in the twinkling of an eye, at the shout, the return of Christ, I will be changed. You will be changed if you're saved and get a new body. Boy, what a blessing that is. Never to sin again. Never to be tempted to sin again. Hallelujah for that great truth today. I pray these devotionals have been a help to you. Tune in next time for another Bread for a Friend.